If there's any organization that deserves to be around for 50 years, it's PHI. All of us have a wonderful time serving on this board, but I have to tell you, the real leadership of PHI starts with Mary Pittman. Mary has done an outstanding job of providing the strategic vision, guidance, and direction in leading the transformation of PHI to a global and national leader in public health.
It really does take all of us working together to build health, and you will see from our incredibly accomplished group of awardees tonight that in virtually every act we take and in every opportunity we make in the world, we also make a difference in health. And that means that educators, advocates, scientists, parents, legislators, city planners, social justice activists, healthcare providers must all be at the table if we are to build a healthier world.
And so I just want to say to Joe and to Mary and to the board, boy, what a ride it's been. It's been a great ride. Happy 50th birthday to you. You look great. The Public Health Institute and California Endowment are collaborating, but in this case, we are working to establish a fellowship and scholarship fund in the memory of one Dr. Tony Yancey.
My parents who are in the room might say, "You little but you talawa," which is Jamaican patois for "you may be small, but you are mighty." Frankly, the way that we get there is by getting a leg up from partners who are giants, like the California Endowment, like Kaiser Permanente, like the other folks in this room who have been tremendous partners in doing this work. Data changes the face of this crisis. It's not just an issue. Early adversity is not just an issue for low-income communities of color. It is everybody's issue. It is California's issue. It is America's issue. And the work that PHI does to be able to tell this story with data is the path to change, to get every single person who needs to be on board to champion and say, "This is my community. I'm going to do something about it." So I just want to say thank you. Wow.
Look what we've accomplished. Best example I could probably give tonight, a 50% reduction in tobacco use since the original Surgeon General's report, causing the IOM to say, that that's the most important official governmental health document ever published in all of history. If we invest in it, public health and prevention, we could rapidly become the healthiest nation in the world, which we clearly are not now. The health, stability, and security of this nation hangs in the balance, and the choice should be an easy one.
If you didn't remember my name, you can call me one who likes beads, because that's what my name means. But it's not just about the beads, the beauty beads that I'm wearing. In my own place, when you do beading, the meaning of it is to be a connector, connecting and staying together. And so my joy this evening in being part of the 50 years board chairs and introducing Abigail, because I would like to call her Abigail the Beader, because she connects the world. I wanted to be here to introduce her, to say the world would honor PHI for honoring Abigail, because she is not here just as someone from the United States. She is here as one that is recognized in every part of the world for the communication, for the advocacy, for the voice that she gives to the women, men, and children of the world.
You know, we care about health because what we really care about is dignity, right? And there may be a wealth gap and there may be a health gap, but the dignity gap is the gap that is really hurting all of us around the world.
Part of what distinguishes PHI, I think, is that it doesn't know simple boundaries. It understands the relationship between equity and health. In recognition of the extraordinary work that PHI does, Kaiser Permanente is making a contribution of $1 million to advance the mission of PHI.
Quiero expresar mis agradecimientos por el honor que me confiere este prestigioso Instituto de Salud Pública, cuya misión de generación y promoción de la investigación, el liderazgo y las alianzas para fortalecer la capacidad de una fuerte política de salud pública, programas, sistemas y prácticas, ha sido ampliamente cumplido a través de estos 50 años de intenso trabajo sobre grandes temáticas de avanzada y que ocupan la atención de la salud pública del momento. Es por ello que con mi agradecimiento al Instituto de Salud Pública de San Francisco, rindo reconocimiento a la que debe ser la gran guía de nuestras acciones y que es mi mensaje para todos: la solidaridad entre todos los pueblos del mundo. Muchas gracias.
I want to thank the Public Health Institute for this honor. My mother used a term to keep us in check. She'd say in Spanish, dime con quién andas y te diré quién eres. That, of course, was sort of to keep us in line, but it's relevant here tonight. In English, that means, tell me who you affiliate with, and I'll tell you who you are. And I want to thank the Public Health Institute for this honor, for the work that they do.
Don't mess with the Public Health Institute, because 50 years of kicking a lot of butt, they're a force to be reckoned with. And I just also want to appreciate the work that PHI is doing around climate change. One of the themes that we're hearing from all of our honorees and the organization is really lifting up the voices of those who are invisible and making them visible, particularly around health. Poll after poll after poll, we see that Asians and people of color and folks in low-income communities in California and across the country care the most about environmental issues and also about climate change and about the quality of the air that we breathe. I think my message here today is that when you invest in communities of color and low-income communities and communities that are most disadvantaged and impacted by these problems, that you actually win significant change. And thank you, PHI, for understanding that and recognizing that and focusing your work on making that happen. And thank you for this incredible honor.
I hope, like me, you're feeling energized from these extraordinary people. And I want to thank all of the awardees for joining us this evening. You've really, I think, set a bar for our work in the future. I want to thank the co-chairs, all of my board members, past board members, all of our sponsors, and all of you who have attended this evening. Thank you so much for making this wonderful celebration of PHI and the work of all of our principal investigators such a wonderful event. And thank you again for an extraordinary evening.